Why do people still fight with swords in Dune? Where are the guns? Let's understand why. We begin with the Holtzman effect. This technology allows the folding of space, the floating of globes so they can repel gravity, etc. What we are concerned with are the shields that are used to protect an individual in melee combat and also from ranged attacks. Like many innovations in Dune, this effect was discovered during the Butlerian Jihad by Theo Holtzman, a mathematician. The Jihad was the scouring of AI out of the technology in Dune. Using the shield generator, a fighter such as Duncan Idaho is protected. According to the Dune glossary, a shield will permit entry only to objects moving at slow speeds. Depending on setting, this speed ranges from 6 to 9 centimeters per second. The shields themselves are not in the shape of a Greek round shield or a Roman scutum, but surround and fit the body of the individual. And so, as above, you must attack at a slow speed in order to penetrate it, and the shield's penetration speed can be amended depending on what or who you are facing. Presumably, with the field, the use of guns to pierce it became pointless, such was its strength. Perhaps the last gun was the only type that might, and then that had consequences, which we will explore below. We can also assume that the martial arts were adapted to suit this new style, where the focus was on slowly getting through the shields rather than getting around the armour to less protected parts. Actually, the shield is rather like armour, wrapping around the body and protecting it. In shield fighting, one moves fast on defence, slow on attack. Attack has the sole purpose of tricking the opponent into a misstep, setting him up for the attack sinister. The shield turns the fast blow, admits the slow kind. Gurney Halleck, the Paul Atreides. The shield also affects the area around the user. If the shield was set too high, it would not permit oxygen to reach its user. So the shield will be set at around 6 to 10 meters per second so that the atmosphere can get through. There are also other dangers with the field in certain environments. The conditions on dunes, sandstorms, etc., for example, are not conducive to the use of the belt, where it will only work for a short time. Also, the vibrations it gives will attract the giant sandworms of Dune. When this happens, the sandworm will be drawn towards it, and the belt will drive the worm into a frenzy. This is caused by something in the Holtzman effect. The lasguns themselves are defined in the glossary of Dune as a continuous wave laser projector, a weapon that projects a beam or blast of energy. Now we've established the shield and lasgun, let's get to the central question. Why are there spaceships and enhanced humans, and yet the fighting is melee? How can this make sense? Frank Herbert, as smart authors do, has explained this to support the type of world he wanted to portray. Now, when the laser of the gun penetrates the Holtzman field around an individual, the result is a nuclear explosion. Exactly the size of the explosion is not known. Sometimes this could be just the shooter and the man in melee, or damage over an area further than atomics can cover. Atomics is the Dune universe term for nuclear weapons. These disputes are settled using melee because the consequences of the explosion mean people on either side will not want that damage to their own people in the army, or the environment around them. Depending on the operation, this explosion could kill people on either side when there are less casualties wanted by both houses, eliminate an important person that one side wanted to capture, such as the Carinos chasing after a member of the Atreides bloodline, damage an area they just want to capture, such as a siege on Arrakis. Siege is the name for small Fremen communities on Arrakis. damage technological assets that the invading house may want to keep, such as technology being developed by the Atreides the Harkonnens might want. The potential chaos of its continued use is endless and would disrupt the life the universe has settled into following the jihad. The explosion can also be used as a tactic. This is done by Duncan Idaho, who uses the resulting explosion to discourage others from doing the same, a warning to them. The God Emperor, Leto II, notes 3,500 years into his reign that shields are banned throughout the Empire, and it is a capital offence to possess one to avoid such explosive interactions. So, the powers in the Dune universe, such as the Landsraad, knowing the damage caused, agree to its non-use and fight in the more classical style of not only hand-to-hand combat, but also small armies such as the Fremen of Dune, fighting the Sadukar of the Emperor. Thank you for checking out my video. Please like, subscribe, and hit the bell for all notifications.